Right, Gary Wood, our social psychologist, is on the line now. Hi, Gary.
Hello there, good afternoon, and how are you today?
I am all right, Gary, all right. We wobble on, don't we?
Just all right. Well, I've got just the thing for you, then.
Oh, go on, then. Pep me up.
Well, there's something in psychology called confirmation bias, and we see it a lot in conspiracy theorists. So what happens is you get hypotheses about something, and then you only look for evidence to support it. You never look for evidence that conflicts in any way.
Yeah.
And we kind of do that to ourselves sometimes. So if something goes wrong, we'll go, oh, it's just because I'm useless. And then we'll spend weeks thinking, oh, it's cool, collect lots of evidence to, you know, categorically prove my uselessness. And of course you'll find it. And yeah, anytime things happen, here we go again. Oh, I'm hopeless, I am. And you actually do hear people talking like this.
Yeah, true.
So we've got a little technique to kind of balance and counter that. And you've probably seen these weekend workshops where they get people to walk on hot coals. And apparently it's supposed to transform your life because you can do anything after that. Well, anyway, I suggest this exercise and everybody says, oh, have you got any hot coals? We'd rather do that. So all you're going to do is you get your phone out and you set the stopwatch for 60 seconds.
Mm.
Then you close your eyes. And then you have to say as many positive, complimentary, praiseworthy things about yourself as you possibly can in 60 seconds. And it doesn't matter if you repeat yourself, as long as you keep going for the 60 seconds.
Right.
So if all you can think of is, I make a great cappuccino, just keep saying that for 60 seconds. And you probably need to do it three times, at least, a few times, just to get the practice in. So, would you be up for that? Not obviously on it, but what do you think of the idea of that, then?
I think it's a good idea. I think that you're right. I think that if I was trying to think of all the things that are wrong with me, I could set that stopwatch for an hour and I'd still be going strong. The nice things or the things that I like, I think that I'd perhaps struggle with the 60 seconds. Can we make it 30 just to stop? Just
no,
to
it has to be 60, so that's why you can repeat. You can't stop, you repeat. But there's a second part to it.
Oh, go on.
And it's why the technique's called mirror, mirror. So I use this technique in coaching for people to help them prepare for things like interviews, first dates, presentations. And in this case, we can use it just to give us a lift of a morning. So you're doing exactly the same. You're setting your stopwatch for 60 seconds. But this time you have to face a mirror and you have to look yourself in the eyes and you have to say positive, praiseworthy things for 60 seconds.
Oh, I've never done that of a morning in the mirror. It's always quite negative, to be fair, as I'm sat there in front of that. And I do have a little chanter to myself, Gary. But so you're saying that it would be better if I were to start the day saying good things?
Well, yes. The thing is it kind of sets you up for what to expect. So it almost like tunes the filter. So if you start off saying, oh, it's rubbish, or your moma, then you're going to, this confirmation bias, you're going to look for more things to support that. Because the brain loves to make connections.
Right.
So if you can start it with a positive, so you're getting out of bed, you've done your breathing exercise, you had a bit of stretching, you've had your cup of tea, you've had your pondering, and then you go up to the bathroom before you shower, you look in the mirror and you say 60 seconds worth of positive stuff to yourself. And you're kind of set for the day. And it's a lot more difficult than it sounds. And most people would probably like to walk on hot coals.
Yeah. That, at the moment, that sounds preferable. You're right.
It is. That just illustrates how strong this bias is to put ourselves down rather than build ourselves up. Because we've got this whole thing, self-praise is no praise at all. And my philosophy is, if you don't praise yourself, nobody else is going to do it.
Yeah.
You have to be realistic because it's based on things you can do, things you've been successful at. So it's based on evidence, not, oh, I'm the king of the universe, I'm the most wonderful person in the world, because then you'd be running for president. So there you go.
I will try it tomorrow and then I'll report back to you when we speak again at this time on how that went.
I think you could be a changed woman.
Well, I could be. I could watch this space. You never know. You could have revitalised me, Gary Wood. What are you doing for the rest of your afternoon?
I'm back on the old writing treadmill, unfortunately, locked away now for another 10 days.
Oh, bless you.
Well, I've nothing else to do, have I?
Well, no, you might as well just crack on with it and get some bestsellers out there while you're sat there.
Well, bestsellers stretching it a bit, maybe. But
we're thinking
we'll
positive. You told me we were thinking positive, so
well,
now
no,
I'm
I've
thinking.
Got, but you've also got to be realistic. So, I mean, if I can finish it and it'll sell a few copies and it will keep me in, I don't know, a nice box of bourbons for the next few months. That'll be fine for me.
Well, we will get you on again tomorrow, Gary, and I'll update you on whether that worked or not. But nice talking to you. And don't forget, if you want to find Gary, go find him on Facebook, OK? Dr. Gary Wood, and you can follow his...
Hi, it's Gary Wood. Thanks for checking out my videos, and please remember to hit the like and subscribe buttons. You can find out more in my books, my blog, or if you're interested in coaching for wellbeing, head over to drgarywood.co.uk to get in touch. Thanks.